notes are with you, right? And this CA people, they have module, right? In module, everything is written on starting. They have given explanation and introduction of 2-3 pages. You read it at your home. If you don't understand, ask your parents. Are everything, I should not answer you. I'm not your parent, okay? And in 500, we cannot give you unlimited services. Yeah, still, if you don't understand, please ask me. But basic thing, you read it. It's not a law. And it will not come in exam. That basic initial pages that they had written only for your knowledge, general knowledge. Shh. Okay? So what is first point that you can see? GST, the game changer. Right? Sir, will it change the game in India? Obviously, it has changed our life schedule. Yeah? And I must say that some people are, you know, they are not happy with GST. Because they are liable to pay tax, no? Who are not happy with GST, you know? Trader. Trader community. People who are dealing in black money. They are not happy with GST. Why? Now they have to pay GST. See, paying GST is not their pain area. Why? Because they have to pay GST by collecting it from customers. Are they can shift the burden, no? But the moment they show data in GST portal, that means they are earning that much. And now they have to pay income tax on at least the income that they had shown in GST. Because GST is linked with PAN, PAN is linked with Aadhaar, Aadhaar is linked with PAN, income tax return is linked with PAN, GST return is linked with the GST number, everything is online. We don't need human to reconcile now. We just need computer language that will identify and find out mismatch in income tax and GST. Okay? So sir, will it change the game? Yes, it has changed. Many people are not sleeping, right? Because of GST. And everybody is waiting that Modi uncle should be gone so that he should not be another few laws, right? And he is not stopping now. See, demonetization was step one. GST step 2, Aadhaar, everything is in line. Linking Aadhaar, Digital India, everything is in line. There are many things that you will see, you will witness, we will enjoy together. As a professional, I was worried about GST. But to somehow I realized that this is my bread and butter. This is your bread and butter, right? So you should not hate GST. Filing 3 return is an exhaustive job every month. Every month 3 return means monthly, yearly 36 return under GST. And one annual return, 37 bonus. Earlier service tax only 2 return. 2 return has been converted into 37 return. Don't you think that service industry is now under pressure? That they have to maintain data on monthly basis, on weekly basis, and they have to update their records. They have to go to chartered accountant, to see chartered accountant thrice in a month. It's painful for industry, but for chartered accountants, vadakkam. Come with the data, come with the GST return, and come with Gandhiji. I'm here. So we were not doing good business. Government was worried about us. GST is the marketing for us. Government is doing. They are bringing more and more client to us. Now isn't it good thing for professionals like you and me? The best thing that GST is happening in India. But to earn money you should study, understand, right? And process has begun, right? What is tax? Friends, what is tax? Can you read what is tax and understand? Achha, tax, payment of tax is optional or voluntary? Mandatory? Obviously mandatory. Sir, but we take it optional. We are chartered account. Sir, you know there is a difference between direct tax and? Do you want me to teach again? No, yeah, you'll understand. Sir, features of indirect taxes. Excellent, sir. Important source of revenue. Is it difficult to understand? No. Right? Tax on commodities and services. Can I shift my burden? Can I shift my burden in the indirect taxes? Yes. Shifting of burden means I have to pay GST, but I'll collect it from you. Right? So I have to issue bill of 1 lakh rupees to my client. Instead of issuing bill of 1 lakh, I'll issue 1,18,000. Burden of payment is on me, but I'll collect it from person who needs my services. You don't want to pay GST? Do not take services. If you want to enjoy services, pay GST. I'm responsible for collection and payment. Okay. Sir, inflationary in nature. Inflationary nature. Do you understand this word inflationary? Because of GST, some commodities has become costlier. Right? On new channel, some people who don't even understand GST, those nonsense people come and say, now TV is going up. Now hotel is going up. They make the chart, no? Before GST, after GST, dekho loot liya sarkar ne. Aur do vote BJP ko. Are? Even if it is a Congress government, even if some XYZ government, these changes were required. Right? And these changes were proposed by Congress government. So there is a whole history written on GST. Okay? Yeah? Next. Next thing we will discuss later, genesis and concept of GST. Deficiency in existing system we will discuss tomorrow. It's a very important thing. Framework. Can you come to framework document? Can you come to framework document? Yeah? India has adopted dual GST. Dual GST means there are two levels, central level and state level. Okay? Sir, destination based tax or source based tax? Destination based tax. Okay? So it is depending on supplying state or recipient state?
Supply. Recipient
state. Supply is taxable. But which government will collect have money? Recipient. We will discuss that again. On intrastate and interstate, can you understand those two words, intrastate and interstate? Yes. On intrastate, two people will collect tax. Yes. Your Maharashtra government plus? Yes. Because Maharashtra is the territory of Maharashtra as well as India. So if you are doing business in Maharashtra, obviously you should pay tax to Maharashtra. Yes. If you are doing business in Maharashtra, obviously you are doing business in India. That's why you are paying tax to 9% to Maharashtra, 9% to India. Okay? Clear? But if you go interstate, pay direct 18% to central government. And central government, what will they do? They'll run away with this 18%? No, obviously they'll divide this money on state. That means obviously, whether you pay for your central government or state government, it will be spent on your area only, for your benefits. Okay? Yeah, next. Legislative framework, we will discuss that. Come turn the page. See, I had covered some different particles. You can see I had to skip some paragraph because whole introduction is not completed. And that's why I told you that for 3 days, you cannot ask me to teach section wise and syllabus wise. 3 days I am creating my foundation. Saturday, Sunday, Monday, give it to me, do not raise any query, just follow whatever is being said. And there will be repetition. Obviously, I'll repeat my sentence. Okay? Because it is for your benefit only. Clear? Yeah? Next. Can you come to constitutional provision? Above constitutional provision, there is a one clause. Taxes subsum under GST. Subsum means these taxes are deleted, gone. No, they are summarized, merged in GST. Okay, there are two types of taxes we had, central level and state level. So some central taxes and some state taxes, they were ready to bring it into GST, but they were not ready to leave these 5 items. Right, an alcoholic liquor for human consumption. They said no, we want it. So central also said okay, we want it then. Excise duty belongs to us. VAT belongs to you. Alright? Liquor for human consumption belongs to you. Liquor for industrial consumption belongs to us. So they see, if you show me attitude, I'll show you attitude. If you cooperate with me, I'll cooperate with you. You scratch my back, I'll ask Anjesh. And then you will lose your back. Okay? Sir, do not scratch my back. Sir, taxes subsum under GST, central excise duty on additional excise duty, service tax, excise duty under Medical and Toilet Preparation Act, CVD, special CVD, these are two custom duty that I was talking about. That out of so many custom duty, only these two came into GST. Central sales tax, surcharge and cess, okay? And in state list, what is merged in GST? State surcharge and sales, so far as they are related to supply of service, entertainment tax, but except why sir? Because still constitution says taxes on entertainment shall be charged by local. Other than this is merged with central. That's, sir, this is legal understanding, and on PPT when they teach on Google and YouTube, no, they just teach this taxes subsum in GST. See, everybody knows this. You people should have legal understanding behind it. This is legal understanding. So if somebody said why, said dip that entry number six, why local authority taxes are not merged with GST? Tell them entry number 62 of state list, that is list 2 of 7th schedule of article 246, doesn't permit government to merge local taxes, local entertainment taxes in GST. It is still there. And that's why local authority will charge it. Legal understanding. Okay. Next. Sir, taxes on lottery, betting and gambling is merged. Entry tax, all forms. And purchase tax is also merged. VAT and sales tax, merge or not merge? Both answers are right. Some merge, some means everything merge other than this. Other than petroleum, high speed diesel, motor spirit, natural gas, aviation turbine fuel, alcoholic liquor for human consumption. Luxury tax is merge. Taxes on advertisement is also merge. Okay. Legal, general. You read anything, I don't mind. You should know that these taxes are merged with GST. Constitutional provision, can you see our federal structure? India has three-tier federal structure. Can you tell me three tiers? Central government, state government and local government. Very good. And every government has power to levy taxes, right? Next, Constitution of India is the supreme law of India. Can you underline that word? Constitution of India is the supreme. Now, these things are not new for you, right? Sir, because we had discussed this from early morning. These things are, you know, which has become very familiar. Haan, sir, aisa hi hota hai. Uske piche ye 3 ghanta humne invest kiya hai. Same feeling you should have in GST Act. That's why we should invest tomorrow day also in GST Foundation. Okay. So Constitution of India is a supreme law. It consists preamble, that means introduction about Constitution. Again, it has 25 parts. Okay. Containing 448. Earlier 444. Now they introduced few more articles because of GST changes. So 246A was not there. Even this can come in your MCQ. Number of articles are there in Constitution of India. 448. Because it is written in your module. Okay. Next. And how many schedules we have? One of that schedule is 7th schedule. Okay. So Constitution of India is divided. Preamble, 448 articles and 12 schedules. All right. Power to collect and levy taxes emerges from Constitution of India. Can you see? Power is emerging from Article 245. Next, if any power is not written in Constitution or not in conformity of Constitution, that law will be called as ultra virus, not virus. No, even I make this mistake while writing. I say ultra virus sometimes, pronunciation. But what is that? Ultra virus. And it's not English word, it is Latin phrase, which means void from beginning, right? It's not valid. It's a completely illegal, invalid law. Okay, invalid word. Article 265 we had discussed, and you can see that highlighted word, same it written there. Article 245 we had discussed. Article 246 we had discussed. Seventh schedule has three parts, and on my board even I had written content of those three parts as amended in 2017. Okay, and now from tomorrow onwards we will discuss Article 246A. So tomorrow also we will discuss about constitutional provision. We'll start from Article 246A. If you have any friend that you want